All right, guys, today is the day that we are finally getting a rooftop RV AC installed on the roof. Right now we have King's Auto Robert in there drilling a hole for us, that way we could place it up on top. We did get the unit off of Amazon. There's mixed reviews, a lot of people saying that it came damaged and they had to return it, but luckily, knock on wood, it's in good shape. So this is what it looks like. Isn't she pretty? And then we got the control panel right here. And it does come with a gasket. We weren't sure if it did, and it did. So yeah, let's go inside and see. Up. Oh. Hi, Jasmine. Oh, you do kissies. Oh. Wow, we got so much done.
Listen, this takes time, okay? Yes. Well, we're getting there, guys. We're starting to cut the hole out. There's a lot of stuff in this roof, and it's making it a little bit more complicated than what I was hoping for it to be. Up, Diana's here. Oh man. Hi, Diana. Goodbye, Diana. Oh, she's about to drive through a flood. All right, let's not get distracted. We gotta pay attention. Come on, Wood. All right, guys, so we are making some headway. We officially got the hole cut from the inside. Now what you're seeing is the fiberglass from the inside. So this is the actual roof itself. So we're gonna drill four corner points, and then with a jigsaw, we're gonna cut this hole out from the top. And then after that, we are gonna start mounting the AC. Woo! How's it going up there, man?
It's going.
So as you guys can see, I had to pull this panel, and we're gonna put it right up next to this one. So I wanted to center the AC, plus we had to go work around the beams. That way we can make this nice clean cut.
Robert.
Say hi, guys.
Hi, YouTube.
Cody, be quiet.
Cody, Robert.
All right, so our hole was a little short. We're gonna cut it up a little wider to fit that vent piece in.
Yeah. Shit. Let's move this back a little bit more. That side's gonna be stuck down.
Why is it so heavy?
All right.
Yeah, there we go.
Move.
That stuff don't play, man. Gonna have a lot of bleeping to do in this video. Alright, so Robert's just finishing up the control panel. Actually, the gasket?
The unit. Is mounted.
Nice. I'm almost official.
It's waterproof.
Good job, Robert.
High five.
Alright. So yeah. What's next?
Clean up this damn mess. What a mess. Show him the mess.
I gotta go. Bye, guys. Alright, guys, can you hear that? We are in the final stages of installing this AC. So for right now, we kind of just jimmy wired it just so it's nice and cool in here because it is gonna pour soon. So we're gonna be in the bus working for a little bit. I don't wanna be sweating to death. So we got it running. Everything is working great. It's blowing nice and cold. And then we got everything. And then over here, we're hooking up our breaker box, right?
See.
How many breakers are we doing?
Two.
And how many can we fit?
Four.
Right. So we're gonna run our wire from here all along the roof for now. It's gonna run over to this corner. We're gonna put the breaker box right here. That way, just in case I ever have to flip it, whatever, it's easy to get to. And we'll be good to go. We're also gonna be installing two outlets right where Robert's foot is, and one right over here by the bed. That way I can plug stuff in. So we're gonna finish up here, and I will show you guys what the finished product looks like in a little bit. All right, guys, we are officially running. Let me close this window. And we are all set up, nice and neat. Got the whole panel on, got air coming out of the front, the back, and the two sides. This unit can be used as a ducted unit if you have vents all throughout your RV, or as a standalone unit where the air will just come out here. So in order to do that, if you had a ducted unit, you would close this, it closes these slots, and it'll send air all throughout the RV. But in our case, since we're just having the air come down, we don't have a ducted air unit. We just open this and it lets the air just fall down nice and calm, and cools the bus down pretty quick. This is a Brisk Dometic Brisk Air 2. This is the 13,500 BTU unit. And it's really nice. It's pretty quiet. You know, it puts out a little bit of noise. Obviously, it's an air conditioner, but it does the job. It keeps it nice and cool in here, and we are thrilled. I am so thrilled to have it, that we don't have to pick this big air conditioner up anymore. Put it in the window, take it out of the window. It gets water all over the bed because it leaks out, because I can never get all the condensation out of it. So definitely recommended. This unit, the AC itself goes for about $800, and the control panel was, you have to buy the control panel separately, and that was about $100. So you're about $900 shipped. And you know, if you can swing it, it is totally worth it. So you might want to look into it. I'm gonna drop a link down below. I ordered mine on Amazon, so shipping was pretty quick. The AC took a little while because it came from California, probably took about a week. The control panel took maybe 2 days. I don't know where that shipped from, but it was pretty quick. So yeah, other than that, guys, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. We're going to get back on a regular vlogging schedule, I guess, starting tomorrow. But I hope you guys are all having a great night. And me, Cody, and Sam, we'll see you guys in the next one.